This was a really interesting water feature and a bit of an interesting story behind the nightmare that the customer's having with it, or had with it, or about to be put an end to with fibreglass, in as much as it is built the pond out of poured concrete and shuttered and then painted with a bitumen based paint. Now you'll see on one of my videos a video titled Pond Paint or Fibreglass, and this is another example of a failed pond paint system. Now when concrete is poured like this, it should be vibrated to get all the air out and get these little air pockets out of it, look. And this paint has clearly failed, despite putting multiple layers on. It's failed to seal the discrepancies in the concrete. You can see an impression, a patterning of what was a tarpaulin that went down over it. He was absolutely desperate. He was that desperate he put a tarpaulin on the floor, because this bitumen based product just would not go off. Now it has mostly gone off. There's no one, I came to look at it the other day, it was coming off on my hand. That feels a tiny bit you know. What is going to be the acid test is, well, there are two ways of dealing with bitumen based products like this and fibreglass. What you don't want to do is just start fibreglassing over this bitumen surface, because the bitumen, if it isn't hardened and set, it will bleed into the resin. So two ways of dealing with it: either overpaint all of this with PVA, and that puts a barrier between the fibreglass and the PVA. What I'm going to do is put a red hot super fast setting. We'll talk about the temperature of this, what is a cold surface, right? Relatively speaking, it'll be a fast setting mix. Yeah, I'm going to overpaint it with that. Now the idea being that that will show me if there is any areas of this that aren't set hard enough and that might bleed into this primary layer of resin. Right, excuse the noise and excuse this wind. There's nothing I can do about it. Wind, it's ridiculously windy today. So primary hit of resin all over every surface will show up if there's going to be any bleed through of any bitumen into the resin. If there is, hopefully it will just be localized, yeah, and that localized spot will be dealt with in two ways: either cover it with foam, hit it with more resin, or put some, I'd call it like a sacrificial layer or so on fibreglass, that because there is a primary layer of resin on it, will bleed into, it will bleed less and less into the more and more material that you build up. But we shall do a primary test area first. In fact, no, I won't. I'll just hit the entire lot with a bit of water getting through some plants that were on there. Just to talk about covers yet again. You know me and my covers. Look what's happening there, look. See, it's getting ragged against that sharp edge, look. And it's tearing it. The customer's going to grab some bits of tape. There's not much you can do about it in this wind. The builder could not get any boards. Supply issue. You know, I did suggest to put the timbers across the top and then board out in between. That stops any water, if it does rain, sagging in and then getting in, and stop the tarpaulin getting ragged about too much. So primary hit of resin to find out how it responds to that treatment, let's just use this towel as an example actually. See a bit of colour coming off that. Just where I'm drying this bit of water up off them plant pots. So that looks like that's been shuttered. I can see a pattern in that concrete. That looks like it's been shuttered with OSB sterling boards. Bit of a nasty lump in that, you know, multiple layers of fibreglass is just gonna smooth that through. Sharp edge on there that the fibreglass is not going to like, but again, multiple layers going over that. Resin will fill that, the fibreglass will bridge it. It's just gonna look, once it's done and once it's glassed, it will absolutely brilliant. And it's gonna hold water, which is the primary purpose of any waterproofing solution that you use. But this paint is too much has been asked of this paint to seal all these porous areas. Maybe if the concrete was vibrated a lot better, it would have been a lot smoother, and then possibly the concrete should have been waterproof in its own right, and then, you know, the pond paint is just a backup and, you know, a cosmetic look to get it looking black. But it is what it is. I'll get some resin on it. I hope that explains why I do certain things a certain way and for what benefit. So let's get some resin, smash it on, see how it responds, let it go off. Now I'm probably going to put something like 3% hardener in it. It's about 19-20 degrees outside, but this is cold to the, you know, relatively speaking to the touch, this is cold, right? So any you know, thermal energy, if you like, any heat that builds up, you know, the exothermic reaction, the heat in the resin, that is going to be lost to that cold surface. And I don't want it slumping down, draining down and creating horrible pools and curtains in the walls. Even though it's going to be covered with fibreglass, I still want to do a nice job from the get-go, yeah? So it's going to be mixed up incredibly fast, so it goes off quick, but it, you know, it can still drain because this is cold. It doesn't do it on foam because, you know, the foam insulates it, and that energy cannot get through the foam, so it sets a lot faster on foam. I'm not going to put foam on this because it would mean putting it on and then cutting all the top edge, or possibly having to take the copings off, which absolutely wasn't an option. So let's get some resin on. Enough talking, let's get some resin on, see how it responds, and then leave it. You know, the reason I was telling you about that is about timing, yeah? There's no point me hanging around here for a couple of hours for it all to set, especially down in a little pit like that where the vapors hang around. I might as well get myself off, go and prepare the materials, come back tomorrow when it's less windy. There's possibly some rain predicted for later on, so I'd rather it rain on this gone off resin than me start the fibreglass in and have this cover fail and wet the fibreglass through. So as always, all things done for a very specific reason. The job's local to me, no rush, it's done. It's done in the time frame that I say so and to the standard that I say so. Because the last thing this customer wants is any more problems. We're here to fix problems, not create them. So it's using an absolutely perfect space, absolutely perfect bit of space to use in this garden, this water feature. Really, really unusual. And once it's fibreglassed, the customer has my absolute assurance that it ain't going to be leaking, not during our lifetimes. This is a faster resin than I normally use for laminating with, but like I say, I want it to go off really fast, and this stuff sets incredibly quickly compared to what I normally use. Get to making that. maybe not quite 3%. Find out how this is going to respond. Looking for any brown or black that comes off on the roller. So far it's not so bad. I've often thought to myself about these pond paints, you'd be better off just painting these ponds out with resin, but you seriously are into professional application of these materials. So that's why, yeah, it's just starting to discolour the roller, look. Nowhere near as badly as it could have done. And it's definitely starting to fill these pores up. Is another reason to do it. Be really careful not to get it all up these front faces of these little slabs. Chunks of concrete falling out the wall. Another reason it probably wouldn't have water. I know that I'm going over bitumen, but it's nowhere near, it's not bleeding anywhere near as badly as what it could do. If I'd have done this a day or so ago when I looked at the job, it would have definitely bled right into it, really nastily. And it was coming off on my fingers. But it's had a bit of time to go off now. The negative effect of the bitumen on the resin, should it bleed into it badly, is that it massively retards it from setting. It won't actually stop it. Other than subjecting it to extreme cold, there's nothing that I know of that will stop it from actually going off once you've got the correct amount of hardener in it.
will go, it's just dragging down on the tape. And what is reflecting is curing process. Sorry about this noise. About what fibreglass system I'm going to use over this in a minute when I've got this on. I'll leave myself a little exit point. Yeah, that edge just there, that's just blacking that bolt up. That is going to be the point of taking the bolts to go on. Just check my hand before I lean on that.
Give you a look at what I've just done. And that's all that's bled out of that, which isn't too bad at all. So I'm 100% confident that when I come back to this, that will all be gone off. Nothing retarded to the point where it slows it right down, but it is still sticky. Let's say there was a localized area like that, then I can easily deal with it. Right, I'll get that tool cleaned up. I think that'll do me for this session, because you don't want to be working. Well, I can't do anything yet anyway now till that's all gone off. And it's just ridiculous working with something flapping around and creating a miver like that. I want to be able to relax as much as this will allow and do this fiberglassing in as controlled conditions as humanly possible to get a really nice finish. So take a good long look at this finish that you see at the minute and compare that to the reveal shot when the fiberglass is all done, all sanded off, all kissed with a bit of paper and flow coated. It's going to look significantly different to what you're looking at right now. Okay, that was a lot of hardener gone in there, so that's going to go off pretty rapid, so I'll get that roller cleaned out. Cheers. In the time that it took me to clean that roller, that has set hard. apart from that slimy bit, look, where all the bitumen was squeezed out of that roller. See the resin set hard, look, at the outer edge. Where the bitumen is, it's retarding it, it's slowing it right down. It will go off, but it'll take time. Even the heat that's generated in the resin portion of that will have a job making that set hard. Anyway, final word on this for this session is these pond paints. There is no doubt that some of them will work, but I just seem to see the shitty end of them. So either something isn't quite in place on the substrate, which I suspect in this case is the concrete not being vibrated properly, or the product's just shit anyway. I mean, I was saying this to a customer the other day, that fibreglass, it's an old technology, it's like 60 years old, but it still works. There's no refuting that, it works, and it works for a long time. I see all these different paints come along, rubberized paints, bitumen based paints like this. And there's just no substitute for fiberglass in the right hands, of course. I've been following a guy on YouTube that's he's fiberglassed his own pond, fair play to him, filled it up with water, and it looks like this. It's all patchy where it's undercured, it's not put enough hardener in. You can see where he's had to go over it again because he wasn't confident, you know, with the finish. Or it didn't go off, or when he's put some water in, it's discoloured, so he's put some more flow coat on. You know, this is... I'm professional at doing this, as you know. Not wishing to blow smoke up my own ass or anything, but, you know, there is a difference between professionals doing this and DIYers. And as I've said before, it's not impossible. It's not impossible to fiberglass your own pond, but you ain't going to have a very nice time doing it. You are not going to find it a pleasant experience. This in here absolutely stinks. It's even offending me it's that strong, because we're pretty well sealed in. Right, you'd see how that's not slumping anymore. It's gone off, it's set hard, so it was retarded by the bitumen. There's no point me fingering and touching that, because I know it's definitely not going to be anywhere near going off. So just sit on it. There's no point looking at it, staring at it, coming back every 10 minutes to have a bit of a touch. How's it getting on? How's it getting on? Walk away from it. Leave it overnight. Come back tomorrow and do a sterling job. And then when all these bits of kit go in, customer will fill it up, go to bed, and when he wakes up in the morning, the water level will be in the same place that it was when he went to bed the night before. Right, that is enough talking. Let's have a final look at it.